This is Wynter, and she is the absolute, one of the biggest blessings of our lives. She's incredible, and we love her so much. She is an absolute fighter from the day that she was born. Early on in the pregnancy, one of the options they provide to you is to do genetic testing. And so I did the genetic testing, which involved a blood test and then a detailed sonogram. So about 2 weeks later, I got a phone call during the middle of the day, and my doctor had told me that your daughter has trisomy 21 or Down syndrome. I could hardly hold in the tears, and it wasn't because, you know, I think any parent, when life looks a little bit different than you thought, I think it's shocking at any point. But for me early on, it wasn't that she had trisomy 21 or that something was different. It was just because immediately we had talked about all of the risk factors and thinking of everything my child might go through that might cause her pain. When Wynter was born, we found out just shortly after that she had an esophageal atresia, which is not something we had any idea that she had. It was something that was going to keep her in the hospital long term. And we didn't know what an atresia was. We didn't know that that meant her esophagus wasn't connected to her stomach. We had a plan for her heart surgery. We knew the surgeon we wanted. We had a plan of action. But with this atresia, we had no idea. We didn't know anything about it, and it just seemed to keep throwing us these curveballs.
The problem was the esophageal gap was too long to be a straightforward repair. So the surgeon and the family reached out to us about that.
To the first Zoom call that I did with Dr. Smithers, I hung up the phone and just cried, because I think when somebody can give you an answer that you've been looking for, it just changes your life. Our nurse the first night, I said, listen, we've been to 4 hospitals and 5 units now. And she said, and this will be your last. And I said, I hope so. And part of me wanted to believe that, but we've just been to so many hospitals, I didn't know. And the day we left here, she said, I see, I told you. And she did. And it was our last.
It's good to see you, buddy. I think a solid 50% or even higher percentage of families we see come from out of state. And we have a program that sees babies and children with these problems really week in and week out. Yeah, so we use a technique of traction suture-induced growth on the esophagus. So you put little sutures on the bottom end and sutures on the top end and pull on those. We were able to do that by a minimally invasive technique or thoracoscopic, but with just small incisions, and over a series of surgeries to gradually grow the esophagus long enough to connect.
So it took 3 stages to connect her. And so he was able to do in about 17 days what initially we were told would take months and months and months to her first birthday.
She was very stable throughout the process. She's doing great. She's making good progress.
Dr. Smithers is Wynter's favorite person. We always joke because every time he comes in the room, she just lights up. You know, to have a surgeon that dedicates his life to something like esophageal atresias and TE fistulas and things that are so, they're not something you hear about every day. It's not something I knew about before I had Wynter, but it's just something that you'll never be able to put into words. You know, he's so humble and he's so kind and he just smiles.
It always brightens your day to get to see a family, hug a baby, especially see them get well and improve over time.
She has been strong and amazing through every surgery, but she is 100% our little miracle girl. But it's just something that you'll never be able to put into words. There's no amount. I've told him before, I'm like, there's nothing I can do to say thank you enough, because you've literally changed Wynter's life.
Winnie, can you say hi to Dr. Smithers and Dr. Shea? Say hi to Dr. Smithers. Say hi. Say hi, Dr. Smithers. We made it. We're one.